so all right, so Judge Leon Wiley, the level where we they enter now, the things that we concern
our
oil. Now the level where we enter no. So make if I'm not too long, so yeah, no. Make we just hear the church army for me with the way IJ carry come for us this morning. How you there, IJ?
I did very fine. Good morning, everybody. We know say the rain don't fall well, well, but not to worry. We get better information from Power Oil today. So today we're going to talk about picky eaters, most especially children. Now, picky eaters simply mean people or person where they to select food or they know they chop some kind of food at all. Sometimes these habits, they start from small and some children they carry and grow. Some children or adults feel they picky or sabi select or reject food because one, they feel they're allergic to that food or the food they bitter or they don't just like them at all. Like me, when are they grow? Okay, I don't know whether you get any experience. Me, when are they grow? I know they feature bitter leaf soup, but now I don't they chop them. But you see the case of unripe plantain porridge, that one, you still get coma. So I don't know whether I use that one and grow, or maybe I know just know why I don't like them. So some people they like that too. You get some food, one or two or three, where they know they chop at all. So many of us out there, if it gets one or two foods, we don't know just they chop for any reason. And some people, even the food, them just discover. Whereas some people will be say, food where they just cook today, then go chop them. They don't know how they take cook them, not. Some people not just get, they go say, me, I know they select food though, which one be that one? Any food at all, they chop them. Now, for children, if it be a thing of concern, especially for the parents, because if it creates serious issues for their health, because their body needs all the energy and the nutrients if it gets from those foods where they know they like chop. But we don't talk and before, make you first of all find out whether an allergy, whether the children they're allergic to something where they cook the food or the food itself. You need to find out which one it be before you go start today. Force your pikin, make it a chop food, or they beat them, make it a chop food. Many of us as adults and they don't beat or no, then beat me, then beat me too. Force me drink akamu. And I notice so many people get that problem. Akamu, they force us drink akamu. But as God will have it, many of us know they drink the akamu. Some elevate, they drink custard. Now so it be. Now these picky eaters, they three types. We get normal picky eaters. This group of people now, they like rice. They like rice generally, but they know they chop fried rice. But if you chop jollof rice, they feature up white rice, share you understand the hair like. So this one they call them moderate picky eaters. This one, they know they chop rice, they know they chop rice. They know they chop eba, they know they chop eba. They know they chop beans, whether you do them as moi moyo or you do them as akara, they know they chop them. They know they chop them at all. This one, severe picky eaters, this group, they know fit chop food where another person cook. If no be them cook them, or then see how they know fit chop them. Their own they so bad where we say if they go party or anything, they go carry their own food along. They not just want chop anything where they don't know who do them unless now them do them. But they say this kind of severe picky eaters, they so now rare something, now just one out of how many people you go fit see get this kind severe picking eating disorder. Now you make they bring them to their knowledge, Power Oil, they bring them to their knowledge. Say something there like picky eaters, and you suppose put eye down because if it no good for your picking health. And you know, say as children, another time they develop all their muscles, their bones, everything where they need. So you really need to watch waiting and they chop and waiting they know they chop and know the reason why. Many parents on top of this matter, then they get sleepless night. You know, some you go see them, they go tell you, say, as my picking just they lose weight. My picking know they chop. Nothing why I go give them. Either you go reject this food, you go reject that food, you go reject this food. If it be saying now, the way you they prepare the food, you know, look attractive for the picking eyes. Sure you get. And when you don't know to say, you don't try different method, you know they work, make you visit pediatrician. Make you visit pediatrician or visit doctor.
Pediatrician now who?
Pediatrician now doctor for children.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, now doctor for children. Make you visit them. Now for some children, when they're very picky, if it be the smell of the food, some people go say, "Ah, too they smell fufu." Say it too they smell. Because of that one, they know they agree chop them. They not go agree put them inside mouth. Some if it be the texture, some go tell you say they not fit chop salad because you just He does the sound. He get as the sound be. Some will tell you popo. He get the kind of sound where they do for their mouths. And then they chop them. So they irritate them. They don't like them. Now make some people know they chop them. Or if it be the taste of the food. Like me, self, he get as he get what he eat, but they chop okwa. Hey, he get as and they do them. I know. But if they fry them, I feel chop them. But if they boil and cook them, like, you know, put all those things, I know they feel chop them. So, if it's make they try experiments for parents, make sure they try experiments with the food. For example, if na yam and your pikin no like boiled yam, you feel make the yam as porridge or yamarita. If you don't know, say, you get this food where your pikin no like, make you find way around that food. Experiment, do one or two things, then know, watch and observe whether your pikin go still chop that food. If he chop them, then you know, say, okay, maybe the pikin no like them like this, but he like them this way, or you no like them at all. Then another one, make parents, they try reduce junk food where they inside house. And many children, they play on with intelligence, so many children know, say, once they don't do like that, but because they know, say, papa and mama want me then chop, then go break the rule just to help them. It no good, make you know, they give them junk food as substitute for real meal. But you fit bribe them with fruits. Picking when they agree chop, if it is okay, if you eat this food, I go buy this thing for you, I go buy this fruit for you, I go buy instead of sweets and other things we no good for their body. Because as you bribe them with the fruits, if they're not to chop that food, at least the fruits go still help them, give them that essential vitamins where they need for their body. Now another thing again, make you try reduce all every form of distraction, especially when you don't reach time to eat. I don't see so many people, they struggle with their children, especially for night. That night food not problem, because children go tell you, I don't want to chop, because why? Their mind, they TV, then they watch one cartoon, then they play one game, or then they listen to one story where their mama and papa they talk, you know. So reduce or minimize every form of distraction as much as possible. So your pikin go fit concentrate for that food. He go fit see the food way he dey chop. Then another one where I notice many parents, the food where they give their children, maybe for morning or for night, not be the food where them they chop at that time too. So pikin go they look and say, for their mind, why mommy and daddy they chop this one? Why are they chop this one? So mama parents, make sure they make sure say, now the same food everybody they chop.
All right, so thanks a bunch, Shilimin. Just one more minute, make a 9 o'clock stand attention. Jejeli and Wiley, we go just do it in now. Open phone line. I know say some of our children get some kind of things, then we be say, some of them they don't want chop this, they don't want chop that. I remember when we grew up, the way we then take, they give us a cam. So they go hold our those, go, blah, blah, blah. They no burn you well not to swallow the
day. I tell blah, you.
Now for laugh, now Baba they keep picky those days. Okay. So for you way day there. Just holler us on top the phone line 2770-951-2771-951-2772-951-273-951. Thank you all the chat where IJ talked this morning. We concern picky eaters. Now what she call this particular one. Alright. Make her just see. Who did the phone line and waiting one? Tell me who did this.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Good morning.
Yeah.
Yo, this is me, Mommy Shala Shepa, calling from Kurudu.
Well done, ma.
Yeah, I work, sir.
We thank God.
My son, superior. The success now, the between two. Success can eat everything. The superior know they eat meat. You know they eat fish. You know they lick orange. You know they eat popcorn. How will I do?
You mean that?
And then I'm all, you know, they eat all those things at all.
Even if you don't eat anything, you must lick orange.
It's now 2 years and 8 months.
Because orange, na vitamin on it, oh no, strong vitamin. Know.
We have mango, see everything. If you boil plantain, you will not eat it, but you fry it to eat it.
Sure, at least you don't get one of the experiments. You don't get the experiments. If you boil them, you know they chop up. Then you like and fried, but now still plantain in the chop.
My dear, now this
is not. Is it good for fried? If fried, is it good for him?
My dear sister, you know, say we no bring doctor come here today or nutritionist. We go tell us waiting good and waiting no good. But then I remember those days. If you no gree chop anything, my mom go just leave you. By the time we hunger, worry you. They know they tell man.
But they are too small. I think they need meat and fish.
They need meat and fish.
They no, not gonna eat too.
Another way where you feed one. Instead where the meat go they chunky like in big portion. If you cut them.
Just make it don't mash the thing. Make it just be like say now. Nah. You know, so some people they know they chop meat, but if you give them sausage and meat the inside, then fit chop them.
Yes. So now make you experiment around that thing. Now for the meat, you fit cut them small, or you fit mash them as Ogayo don't talk. The pikin no go know say nah meat. You fit even mix them inside the food as you they do them. You no go know when he they chop them. Say nah meat he they chop. You know, kids they smart, but we smart past them, so we need to outsmart them.
You still really worry me. I was very happy when I hear this morning.
Oh, thank you very much. And again, as we don't encourage, you fit find pediatrician or bring the tell your doctor about them. He go fit advise you better.
All right, thanks Abanche for that particular one.
You're welcome.
Now so it just be today, no time, no need because when I go fit pick be that this morning. I beg you, just round up this morning.
Okay, so I happy say this woman talk about this thing this morning because there's so many things where they worry parents and many don't know the way forward. So as we don't encourage you now, make una experiment around the food, make una minimize distraction, make you reduce junk food inside house, then finally talk to a doctor or a pediatrician. Now this one power oil they bring to every parent today.
It's good for me, it's good for you, for a healthy family.